Welcome to another episode. Today's question is, what are the long-term effects on the brain for getting too much information in too less time from the internet? So I'll repeat the question. What are the long-term effects on brain for getting too much information in too less time from the internet? Otherwise, it is about information overload. The questioner is asking about the information overload. So let us find out the definition of information overload and its negative effects in physical and mental health. So first is information overload, the context and causes by David Allen and T.D. Wilson. At the personal level, we can define information overload as perception on the part of the individual that the flows of information associated with work tasks is greater than that can be managed effectively. So this is otherwise, like, you know, you receive information, some basic information are required to perform your task. Without inputs, you can't perform any technical task or even otherwise. Even for a small thing like transportation, you should have the information of the bus or train service, how to go there, how to reach the other end, what is the cost of the ticket, all this information you require. Without that, you can't plan your work or your outing. So some information is required for every task. But in technical or in your job, you require a lot of information to start your job. You have to see the consequences, the rules, the requirements of your client or somebody or the government. So much of information is required for you to start your work, plan your work and carry out. But at some point of time, the information, there is too much information that you can't perform your task properly because a lot of unnecessary information, superfluous information comes to you, which you will have to analyze, segregate and take out what is required. So your work or your planning gets delayed considerably and your brain is stalled because of too much information. It is not one task which you are going to have. There are too many tasks and too much of information with respect to every task. So you are bogged down. You can't proceed. You can't analyze that information. What is relevant and what is irrelevant. So the information becomes a negative impact. Initially, with some little information, it required more information. There is a point where you got all information that is required for your work, but then it becomes superfluous, a hindrance. So that is the information overload. So this potential for overload existed ever since information became an important input for human activity. The scientific disciplines from the 17th to 19th century grew a lot. So a lot of information flowed in, and it was impossible for anyone to keep abreast of all the information, whatever is happening. And in some fields, the discoveries were so much and information available was so much that it was impossible to keep abreast of the information even in a particular field, in a particular specialization. So even an expert in a particular field, he is unable to keep abreast of all the information available in his field itself. So what are the factors which contributed to information overload? Increased communication, globalization, deregulation, downsizing and technology. And what are the effects of information overload? You will see that 38% of the managers reported that they are wasting substantial amounts of time looking for relevant information. So time is wasted. To pick relevant information, managers had to spend 38% of their time through the pile of information. And second is delayed decision making. Managers, 48% of the time is wasted in making decisions because of too much information. Too many factors are put into play. So they wasted 48% of their time. And distraction, 47% of the respondents reported that they are distracted from their main task. Then the stress leading to tension with colleagues, loss of job satisfaction. This is nearly from 40 to 60% had problems on ill health, reduced social activity and tiredness because of the information overload. Information overload causes and symptoms we will see. This is by Joseph Raff. 20 million words of new technical, this is based on survey on 2001, that is nearly 19 years back. Status, now it does improve, means the projection will be much higher, very much higher. In 2001, as per 2001 study, 20 million words of new technical information are recorded each day. And if you are reading 1000 words per minute and spend 8 hours a day, it will require you 6 weeks to read what is published in a single day. That is 20 million words. To read that, you will require 6 weeks. But in 6 weeks, you would have accumulated 500 years of reading material, which you have to read if you have to know everything. This is 20 years back. Now you can't imagine today what will be the status. So that is the information flow, or which is available, information which is available. That much of information is going to come to you. So response time to email have shrunk from few days to few minutes. No, earlier people used to write a letter, and for you to respond, it will take time. You will take a couple of days, and then you will send it. It will take maybe a week or two, depending upon the distance, for the letter to reach. So you had a lot of time in between many letters which you used to come, couple of days to respond, because of so much time involved in the physically the letter going and coming out. Now you receive information instantaneously through email. So you have to respond in few minutes, and some cases if it is urgent, maybe a few seconds, people expect your reply if it is top urgent. So you don't have time to contemplate or sleep over it and judiciously consider some decisions. Your decision should be in minutes or seconds, and your response should go. So what is the result of this? We are spending more time at work, we are working at home. Tasks requiring more than 30 minutes of coherent thought must wait till weekend. You have to respond within minutes. That's some complicated problem which requires 30 minutes of your time has to wait till weekend, and much of our time is spent on unplanned events day to day, and make quick decision with minimal analysis. Job satisfaction is becoming merely a concept. In his book Stopping, How to Be Still When You Have to Keep Going, psychotherapist David Kuntz talks about patients who come to him at the end of their rope and in tears. While they are highly successful, very intelligent professionals, they are in trouble, anxious, stressed, unfocused, irritable, unable to sleep, overwhelmed by life, and frustrated with their inability to manage it. This is in 1998, nearly 22 years back. Sorry, 22 years back. Often these patients report that they are not even aware of the cause of their problems. Kunz finds that these patients have no underlying psychosis, no personality disorder, and no family problems. They are normal human beings living a normal human life. Then, why this problem? Their lives have simply become more than they could handle. They cannot handle their life. While not the only the cause of these feelings and symptoms and information overload can be a significant contributor. Here the significant contributor of the problem is information overload. To deal successfully with the information overload, we must first recognize the symptoms and determine their causes. We then seek strategies that will resolve the problem. Here are just a few of the symptoms of information explosion. It is called information fatigue syndrome and includes the following symptoms: poor concentration due to the overloading of the short-term memory, polyphasic behavior or multitasking, often resulting in diminished rather increased productivity, hurry sickness, which is the belief that one must constantly rush to keep pace with time, pervasive hostility resulting in a chronic state of inability, near anger or even rage, habituation or overstimulation which causes the brain to shut down and enter a trance-like state. Plugged in compulsion is the strong need to check email, voice emails and internet in order to stay in touch. Traditional stress including lowered immune response, endocrine imbalance, and depression and the chance of and the experience of burnout. These are the results, these are the problems of information overload, which is called information fatigue syndrome. So that is the problems which will occur to you if you are dealing with the information overload, and most of us have to deal with that information overload and the syndrome effects of it, which are serious, quite serious for managers in the upper level. Even workers had to deal nowadays with a lot of information. They just can't blindly go and work. They are having a lot of inputs which they should be aware of, they should follow. And managers, it is tremendous amount of information because of the risk involved, which are too high. So with this, we'll end this episode. Stay with me for another episode. Thank you.